Welcome to Entrepreneur's Holiday Party. I'm Pat Carone, and here with me is Pam Wiznitzer.
Nailed it. Totally nailed it.
Master mixologist, and we're really excited to have her here because we are kicking off our holiday party, and she's going to make some fantastic drinks for us. So I'm ready. I'm a ready and willing guinea pig.
Nice. Good. So you ready to get your hands dirty a
My
bit?
Hands dirty, my stomach full of alcohol.
Oh, good,
and,
good.
And, yeah.
It's totally in the spirit of the holiday season.
Exactly.
Right?
I mean, this is the only time that it's actually kind of encouraged for you to get, you know, have some drinks with your coworkers, perhaps even to excess, you know, that and what?
Really big family reunions.
Yes, exactly.
Yeah.
All right, well, let's get going.
Yeah, so we have a big assortment of cocktails for today, and that's because when you entertain for guests, you need to make sure there's something for everybody. But we don't want anything that's too complicated, because I want you to be able to do this at home.
I'm very simple.
Yeah, simple. And we
very
want you
simple.
To do this at home as well. So let's go through a few cocktails that you can make. You're going to help me a little
bit. I will help you. And by the way, if you have any questions, just throw them in the comments. If we don't get to them now, we'll get to them later. We'll answer them.
We'll check that. All right, so the first drink we're going to make is a sidecar. Sidecar is a classic cocktail.
Made
with brandy, but we spice it up a little bit for the holiday season. We're using Bertu over here. And Bertu is a brand new product in the market. And it's a brandy that comes from California, and it's blended by two incredible men, one named Jeff Bell, who is an award-winning mixologist, and Thomas Pesuchek, who's an award-winning sommelier over at the Nomad Hotel.
Great.
So you know this stuff is good.
Sounds good.
The juice is good.
Hey.
All right, so when we are making drinks and cocktails, we're always going to start with the least expensive ingredient. So we have lemon juice, which is going to be in the sidecar. We're doing 0.75 ounces of that. So you're going to fill up your jigger, and you're going to pour that in. In a sidecar, traditionally, we have a triple sec, a Cointreau or something, but I like to change it up a little bit. We have over here Italicus, which is an award-winning product. It won Best New Product in 2017. So this, you know, the juice is good in here, right?
I believe it.
And it's made with bergamot. So as opposed to other citrus you might see, you rarely get to see
bergamot. Sounds like a Bond villain.
I mean, I think that was, you know, definitely one of them.
Yeah, definitely.
So we're going to take that. We're going to have We're actually going to do 1 whole ounce of that because it's actually going to add the sugars into the drink.
Now, measurements are very important, right? Like,
yeah.
That's the one thing you really need to be kind of anal about,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, cocktails are a lot more like baking than it is like cooking. You can't
right.
just be like, bam, with some
this
salt.
This tastes
or, like,
good. I like
salt
this. Let's
that.
Throw it in. Right.
Right. You need to be very precise with
good
what you're
salt
doing.
Baying, by the way.
Oh, thank you.
I heard it's the new DAP.
Just like that. So we're going to take the Bertu, and we're going to do 1.5 ounces. I do understand for you at home, a jigger might not be so available, so you can also use shot glasses, knowing shot glasses tend to be 1 ounce, so you can do 1.5 shot glasses, or OXO has this great one that you can use at home, easy to use with the measurements. Before we shake up our sidecar, the real beauty of a sidecar is going to be the rim on the glass. Typically, you use just plain sugar, but today I spiced it up, haha, pun totally intended, with a little bit of ground cinnamon and ground allspice.
Smells great.
Yeah, you smelled it just right when it came out the container,
yeah, exactly.
Right? So when it comes to rimming your glass, it's very easy to do, and all you have to do is take a citrus. You can do a lime, a lemon, an orange, and you're going to roll the glass on the outside for the amount that you want to cover it in. So just roll on the outside, not the inside. That's how we get all the messiness inside the glass with the cocktail.
I like that you do a little bit on the side. You know, some people
yeah.
just...
Yeah, you don't want to go all the way.
When I
in.
Say some people, that's me. Just kind of do it like that. But
yeah.
you get a little more on there.
Yeah, just a bit more. I mean, come on. It's a sugar rim.
Yeah.
You know, you want some. You're going to tap it off, so make sure nothing comes out. And then we're going to shake. You're going to help me shake this cocktail.
All right.
He's like ready to go. Okay, don't worry about that big ice block.
We got plenty.
Yeah, there's tons of ice. Don't worry. So we're going to get some ice in the glass first. All right. And then we're going to add ice into the drink. We're going to seal our shaker. I'm going to get started. Just like that. And then I'm going to pass it off while we watch you shake. Good technique. A little harder. There we go. You see how he's like really chilling down the tin? That's really important for the drink.
Very important.
I always like to say at the end,
it's
now
cold.
That you've done that, if you can make a smiley face into your tin, that's a happy cocktail. So we're going to open up that tin over here.
Great.
We're going to strain out the contents into our glass. And there you have a wonderful winterized sidecar for your enjoyment.
That looks beautiful.
So that's for you. I think you should
you
hold
sure?
on to that. Yes.
All right.
Because we have to make more drinks.
Cheers. Okay.
So if you are into the brown spirits, I say, why not
this
get
is
yourself?
So good.
You like that?
I really do.
We're not done yet.
Okay.
That's the first drink.
All
if you're
right.
into brown spirits, old fashions. Here we have New Riff Bourbon, which is a newer bourbon to the market. It's made in Newport, Kentucky, which is just over the bridge from Cincinnati. Really phenomenal product, has a lot of great flavor. We're going to be making an old fashioned with it, but again, change it up a little bit. Instead of regular Angostura bitters, we have these New England spiced cranberry bitters from Bitterman's. Get it?
Cranberry. Sounds holiday-ish as well.
Very holiday-ish. So we're going to add a bit of that into a stirring vessel down here. I took that same sugar that I used and I turned it into a syrup. So all you have to do is add a little bit of hot water and a 1-to-1 ratio, and you're going to do a small bar spoon of that into the glass as well. It depends how festive you are. You can do 1.5 ounces, but I like to say a good hearty 2 ounces of spirit is really great in an old fashioned. And then we're just going to add some ice again, right?
Yeah, more ice.
And the best part about this drink is that you can make it in a separate vessel like we are doing right now, or you can actually make it in the glass. So you don't have to get fancy like I am right now. You can just make it in the glass.
Save some dishwashing later.
Absolutely. Less
than that. Who wants to be handling dishes after you've had a few cocktails, right?
Not me.
Yeah,
I want to be handling the alcohol, which is what I normally do. All right, we're going to add ice into the glass. New ice as often as we can because we don't want to use the old ice that we stirred with. We're going to take
because then
that.
The flavors from the other one get in there.
Yeah, because the ice is already diluted down, so it's not as cold. It's already used a little bit.
Okay.
You don't want used ice.
No used ice.
Yeah, you want new ice. All
new
right.
ice.
Into the glass. Then it's up to you. A traditional old fashioned is going to use a lemon peel. You can do that. You can also use an orange peel.
Okay.
I'm going to use a lemon, though, because I really like the bright acidity that's
yeah,
going to be.
Yeah, that seems very appealing.
Man, if this doesn't work out at the magazine, I think you have a career in comedy.
Wow, thank you.
Yeah, you're going to express the oil.
No one else will agree. Okay.
No, and that's going to be your old fashioned.
All right.
You can have that unless Alec wants to have it, but yeah.
There we go.
Or for the guest at home. All right, so.
I'm going to take another sip of this, by the way.
We have 2 drinks down, and we have so many more to go. But 2 other really like great cocktails I wanted to show you how to make. One's going to be a sparkling cocktail because you can't have a holiday season
yeah,
without
I mean,
bubbles.
There you go.
Bubbles. So we have one of my favorite spirits. It's going to be Laird's, which is a premium applejack
right.
made here in the United States. 9th generation distiller. Her name is Lisa Laird Dunn. So if you want to spend your dollars this season, support women. Support a woman who's making an incredible product, right?
Yep, absolutely.
You've got the power to do that. We are going to make a sparkling cocktail with this as the base.
Now, Applejack is like super old school. Like, this is what like George Washington drank.
Yo,
right?
This is like the old school stuff because they're like, look who we have here in America. We have apples.
We have apples.
So we're going to make something
let's get drunk
really,
from those.
Really fantastic. Oh, yeah. Look, they can ferment.
Yep, there you go. That's
incredible.
All you need.
Incredible. Science. All right, so we're going to build this in the glass. And the cool part about this drink is that you can actually make this into a pitcher drink. So if you're like, I don't want to make individual
right.
drinks for 5 people.
Yeah.
Let's put in a big pitcher mm-hmm. and you guys serve yourself. So we're going to do 1/2 ounce of fresh lemon juice, like always fresh. Never buy it from the store. Please promise me that you'll never
oh, yeah.
buy it from the store.
Never.
Great. I made a cranberry syrup using 100% cranberry juice mixed with some sugar. We're going to do 0.75 ounces of that into the drink. This is great because it's like a great color for the holiday season.
Oh, sure.
You know? We're going to add 1 ounce of the Laird's Applejack. Many reasons. First off, this is a bottled and bond product, so it's 50%, so it's 100 proof.
Strong.
So it's a little bit stronger than your normal 40% spirit. And also because we're going to top it off with bubbles. There we go.
So this is like a triple hit here.
Yeah, this is everything all in one. So, and make sure when you're pouring bubbles, you pour it nice and slow.
Nice and slow.
Because if
otherwise
you do it too
it's
fast,
all bubbles.
Yeah. If you do it too fast, you're going to... It's going to be amateur hour at the Apollo
oh,
Theater,
yeah.
you know?
No, that's right, yeah.
It's not going to work out very well for you. A light little stir, all right, because we need to make sure that all the bubbles are incorporated in. And then we're going to finish it off. Just really simple. Don't go crazy. Just some
oh,
cranberries.
Nice.
Just cranberries float. Right?
That's great. I bet Santa would like this one.
Yeah, this is, I mean, you could put out milk for Santa, or you could put out this cocktail.
Yeah, let Santa be happy.
Yeah, so.
I mean, the guys, I mean, although you should never drink and ride your sleigh.
No,
you have to,
no
you have
slaying
to be careful.
And drinking.
That's like, cheers, I'll try this.
Cheers to you. But you should always slay in life.
We'll go on the road together, yeah.
Beyonce's
this
watching,
is
right?
really good.
Awesome, I'm glad you like that.
Oh, I love it.
Oh, good. Oh, great. Well, there'll be tons of it at the party. The last
Perfect.
Cocktail that we are going to make is a plan a Negroni. Negroni has risen to be like such a phenomenal
very,
cocktail.
Very trendy drink.
Super trendy.
But it earns the trend. It's wonderful.
Yeah, it's a great drink. It's really easy to make because it's equal parts. So again, if you don't have a jigger at home, this drink is just idiot proof because you take a shot glass, you fill up the same amount of liquor three times, and that's it.
Got it.
So instead of gin, we're actually going to use a really robust base. We're going to use Sombra Mezcal, and Sombra is a really great product because it's made from one of the most sustainable distilleries in the world.
That's awesome.
They really care about the way that they make this product. Also, it's got really a wonderful aroma on it. It's got a lot of smoke on it because it's a mezcal, of course.
I like how you make us feel good while we're consuming these products.
Yeah,
you know,
of course.
Like shop, it's you know, at the right places when
drinking.
You can.
Yeah. I mean, you gotta always think about the right reasons
to
buy alcohol.
Yeah.
Right? So we're actually gonna make this drink in the glass because you don't have to stir this in another vessel, plus less mess, and let people do it themselves, right? We're gonna use Campari, a nice bittering agent.
That's the classic thing for Negronis, right?
Yeah, Negronis were originally made with Campari. You can't beat it. It gives it that bright red color, also very trendy for the holiday season.
Yeah, for sure.
Yes. And then finally, the sweet vermouth. Today we're gonna be using Cocchi Chirino for that.
Yeah.
So there's tons of sweet vermouths. Remember, once you pop this, it's a fortified wine. You got to put it in the fridge.
Got to put it in the fridge. And even then, it doesn't last forever.
Doesn't last forever.
I always buy the small ones whenever
that's
I get
smart.
A sweet vermouth.
That's smart of you. You can always drink this on its own. However, once you open it, it's got about somewhere between 3 to 6 months, depending how often you open it from the fridge.
Right.
But do refrigerate this at home. Okay. So we have all the ingredients in our glass. We're just going to add some ice into that. And add a little bit more. And do you want to stir the drink?
Sure.
Want to stir your drink? All right. So you're going to stir up your Negroni?
All right.
Around and around?
No, I feel like I'm not stirring it because I'm just making all of the ice move along with it.
But that's stirring.
Is that
fine? You're diluting. You're doing a really great job. Okay. So great. You can bartend my holiday party.
Yeah?
Yeah. No, you can't.
That would be quite a switch, huh?
But maybe I'll invite you. All right. So you
I definitely do not look as good doing this as you do.
Oh, thank you.
That's, you know.
Yeah, but you got the...
Oh, yeah, look at that.
Yeah, I got it.
Hey,
I got
I'm holding a microphone here.
Yeah, I know. Two things at once. Look at
right?
that.
Right? I can't multitask.
All right, so we have an orange peel. You can do an orange slice or an orange peel. I like the aromas that come off the oils on the peel, so we're going to add that in. And then here you have your nice Mezcal Negroni, which is how I typically like to drink them anyways.
Great.
You still up for drinking?
I mean, sure.
Yeah.
I will finish all of these, by the way.
I'm not challenging you, but...
I'm just saying, they're not going to waste.
Listen,
okay.
I'll
like put them by my little cubicle.
Tis the season.
Yeah, indeed. Well, cheers.
Cheers. And then a few other things that you can offer at a party while you're finishing that are sometimes highballs. You love that, right?
Ooh. Oh, it's good with the mezcal.
It's so great with the mezcal because it really brings in like a multi-dimensional drink. So instead of just
ooh,
regular Negroni,
nice.
You get smoke, you get bitter, you get a little bit of sweetness, and it all sort of comes together. So as many sensations as you can get in one cocktail.
I love it. I get the sensation.
Like
indeed.
An everlasting gobstopper.
Exactly.
Yes. Yes. So we have a few more things. Are you following down the line? Sometimes you don't want to prepare a cocktail. You just want to put out a spirit and say, go for it,
sure.
Right? So we have a really great Irish whiskey. A friend asked me the other day, what's a good Irish whiskey to get? Sling Irish whiskey is really phenomenal. It's a newer product that came out. And it's finished off in sherry barrels. So it has this beautiful roundness that comes with it. This can be served on the rocks or neat. So we have our nice little shoddy glass over here. And we're going
go
to...
Shoddy.
Go shoddy. It's the holidays.
It's the holidays.
We're going to drink like it's the holidays.
Indeed.
Is this how I get my rapping endorsement
yeah, this is,
deal?
Yeah.
Right. So you're just going to add 2 ounces to a glass. You can drink it that way. You can drink it on a little bit of ice. I like a few rocks into it. I think it opens up that way. Water absolutely helps to open up spirits. That's a good thing to know. I'm going to let you try that.
I'll take a sip, and then maybe we'll pass it on to cameraman Alec.
We can't let him film and drink.
Yeah,
know?
No. Then it'll get shaky.
Yeah.
Mmm. So
how's
smooth.
That? So good, right?
Yeah. Really good.
That's a phenomenal choice to put out for people.
It's in the Alec fund.
And then sometimes you just want a highball because highballs are way easier to handle. Also, if people are dancing at your party, it's easier to like get down with this than it is to get down with a martini glass.
Yeah.
Okay. So
don't forget, if you have any questions about any of these recipes or you know figuring out about cocktails, just put them in the comments and we will get back to you and answer them.
As long as we can remember.
As long as we can remember. Yeah. Maybe it might be tomorrow. Just.
It could be. So I already put.
It could be next
it
week.
It could be yeah. after New Year's.
2019.
So I put 2 ounces of alcohol into the glass already. You can see right here. And this is actually a drink called a Mamie Taylor. So here's the fun thing about highballs. They all have real names.
Okay.
But we never use, like, a Cape Codder is going to be a vodka cranberry.
Right.
So this is a Mamie Taylor. And a Mamie Taylor is named after a phenomenal woman who was a Broadway actress. I was going to say,
it sounds like an old school, like...
Oh, she was a badass. She loved to go sailing on the ocean, and she would drink scotch with ginger.
There you go.
And so they named it after her, because, you know, the woman knew what she liked.
She did.
So we have the scotch in the glass. We got Benrech Scotch, which is a 10-year single malt that's peated from the space side. So if you're looking for something really great to get somebody, this is a really great product right here. A good bottle to mix with, a good bottle just to sit by itself. And it's aged 10 years. I think this is a perfect age to, it's a perfect age, is all I'm going to say.
Perfect.
And then we're mixing it with a premium mixer, Fever Tree Ginger Beer. Fever Tree is a premium tonic water company that comes over from the UK, and they have loads of different flavors that you can mix with. We're going to be mixing with one of their tonic waters in a bit, but this is their ginger ale, and it's very robust.
Got it.
That's why I really like it, because you get a lot of ginger flavor that comes out of it, more so than your average soda can that is ginger ale. Mamie Taylor's finished off with the lemon peel. Really simple.
This Negroni is killer. That again?
You gotta keep drinking.
Oh my God. All right.
You gotta keep drinking.
I maintain my pledge. Okay?
Yeah.
I will finish all of this.
This is the holiday party challenge.
Oh, this is great too.
Yeah, that's so great, isn't it? You get the little bit of peatiness, you get the spiciness from the ginger,
yeah,
and the
really
bubbles.
Nice.
Really refreshing. Highballs.
Really?
Uh-oh.
Oh, guest appearance.
He's not lying.
Not lying. Hey, you know what? We got a few more here.
Yeah, a few more you can finish up.
All right, well, go ahead.
And then we have one last drink over here. It's a really special time of year because Fever Tree collaborated to make a special tonic water that goes with Patron. It is a citrus tonic water. So this is brand new to the market.
All right.
So you're one of the first people to try it.
One of the first.
In the world. Don't you feel special?
Very. I mean, I've been feeling special since
this is my holiday gift to you.
Well, thank
Not
you.
Not all of this,
no,
but this
I like
is my
it.
Holiday gift to you. Yeah, so
I'll literally be a tastemaker.
You are a tastemaker. Look, if you know all else fails, you can just be a bartender with me.
Yeah, no, okay. I love it. We'll go on the road.
So we're gonna add that tonic water.
Did you put the cheaper stuff in first? Yeah. Not that it's cheap, but
no. So we put the Patron in first. That's at the bottom. So obviously,
oh, you put it in first.
Mm-hmm.
Got it.
That's
oh.
at the bottom of that, and
Got
then
it.
We topped it with the citrus tonic water. Now it's up to you what you want to put into this. You can add orange, lime, lemon. I like orange, and actually we're going to cut ourselves a little bit of orange, so just a little wedge over here.
Okay.
Kids, don't try this at home, okay?
Orange, you're glad you brought that with you? Actually, oranges are the one thing we do have.
All right, and that's going to be a little wedge over here that we're just going to put onto the glass.
So good with a knife. I'd chop my finger off.
Yeah. Sharp skills over here. And the last drink for you.
Wow, I mean,
talk
about a trooper, right?
Mm-hmm. You're really taking one for the team over here.
Ooh.
Very good.
It's like a little subtle.
Yeah.
I like it.
That's a killer over here. That's a killer. So it's fun. As you see, there's a huge assortment of drinks. Some of them are a little bit more challenging to make, but not really, no more than 4 ingredients. Some of them are just really easy to mix with. The biggest thing is making sure you have friends to drink with during the holiday season.
Absolutely. And speaking of friends, I think, are you ready to open this up?
Yeah, I think we're ready to mix this up.
This is our holiday party, so folks, you guys want to kind of come and start having some cocktails?
I was like, yeah, we want drinks, so.
We know this guy's going to come.
It's a party of two people.
Yeah.
So.
Well, thank you. Wow, I've been watching from over there and drooling. So
he's actually been getting drunk through osmosis.
Yeah,
it's
yeah,
pretty
okay.
impressive.
He could just smell it, and he was getting drunk.
Pam, thank you so much.
Thank you.
And we're so excited to have you here and to kick off this party.
Let's do it. Now let's make roll the sleeves and make drinks for everybody, right?
All right.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Happy holidays.
Happy
responsibly.
Holidays.